Look, there's been a huge number of rumours and speculation about what I was doing. The funniest one I've heard thus far was that I was in fact becoming a Virgin captain, and we were announcing it today. Second funniest so far was that I was buying Virgin in Australia. he liked that one. I never thought this would happen. I never thought that I'd be swimming in a competitive way again. I'm very glad that I am. I'm glad that, you know, I've spent 4 years away from the pool, and I needed those 4 years. And, you know, what it means now is I'm returning to competitive swimming, slightly more mature. Actually, I think I'm a little more, I'm more immature now, but you know, I'm back in, and I'm happy with what I'm doing. I'm probably forgetting a whole heap here. I've had a great team around me, and I really have to thank them for keeping this quiet, you know, and not telling people for such a long time. I gave head coach of Swimming Australia, Lee Nugent, a call. I told him to sit down, I think he was in India, so he may have already been doing that. So I asked him what I'd need to do to get myself, you know, back into kind of being an elite swimmer again. And so Lee started texting me the swimming sessions that I'd have to do. I know text message gets most athletes in trouble, but they've worked well for me. And this is basically how I've been coached over the last 3 months. I was really sneaky about how I did my training. I've been swimming at 8 different pools so that I wouldn't turn up to the same pool twice in a row. I've slipped up once in that time. You know, I've trained at the usual pools like Sutherland and Caringbah. I also have to thank Ray Paxton, who's the principal at Waverley College, who lent me a pool, which was the only pool in this entire period where I've actually been able to bring Lee in to watch my swimming. And also Bernard Savage, who's been on board doing my dry land program throughout this entire period. I'm doing breaststroke. No, I've decided, look, I've looked at where I think I can actually have the most value with the Australian swimming team. And I think it is the relay events. So I'll be swimming for the 100 and 200 freestyle. I'm actually placing a priority around the 100 rather than the 200, which may surprise a lot of people. But this is what I think I'll be able to add and contribute to the team in the best way. It was on my bucket list to swim at another Olympics before I was 30. That, playing James Bond, starting a rock band, and being a pilot, and this seemed the most realistic. Yeah, it's big. It's enormous. I am prepared, and basically what I'm prepared to do is I've had a almost flawless career, and I put that at risk. And so it would have been a lot easier to sit on that and not do a thing. But, you know, I still have a desire that there's things in swimming that I haven't done that I would like to achieve. So that's, you know, the balancing act of where fear comes in and where motivation. And it's a great place to be on that edge when it comes to trying to get a performance out of yourself.